Hello everyone. Among the wide classifications of surveying, we'll discuss about chain surveying in this video, which is the oldest and simplest form of surveying. When it comes to defining chain surveying, it is a process of taking linear measurements or horizontal measurements between two points. As I already said in the first principle of surveying, that is working from whole to part, you have to divide the given area into a network of triangles or trapezoidal areas so that each individual triangles and trapezoidal areas are found out, and finally the areas are summed up to get the final values. Other than linear measurements, angular measurements cannot be found out by chain surveying, and since the invention of chain surveying, we have so many other techniques to find the linear measurements. However, the chain surveying was used in the following situations. First of all, the ground should be flatter without any undulations, because there may be chances of error accumulation since chain surveying is not very accurate surveying. Secondly, the area surveyed should be very small. If it is a larger area, then the work becomes very difficult in chain surveying. And thirdly, for large scale mapping of smaller areas, we'll be using chain surveying. Like any other surveying technique, chain surveying also aims to prepare plan of the given site. With the help of linear dimensions, the area of the plot can be perfectly calculated. And finally, the boundaries can also be marked with the help of chain surveying. Triangulation is the only way chain surveying is going to work, and that too in triangulation, the triangles formed should be a well-conditioned triangle. What is well-conditioned triangle means any angle formed in the triangle should not be less than 30 degree and it should not exceed 120 degree. Such triangles are called as well-conditioned triangles, and chain surveying is also called as chain triangulation. The following are the instruments used in chain surveying. Basically, chains are used for measuring the distance. Tapes are also used in some conditions. Ranging rods and offset rods both look similar in appearances. Crosstaff, which is used to set perpendicular offsets. Arrows used to mark the intermediate stations. Pegs, wooden pegs and iron pegs. And finally, plumb bob is used to level the instrument. In chain surveying, knowing the instrument is very, very important, particularly the use of chains or tapes based upon the situations we have to analyze. And then we have arrows, wooden pegs of length varying from 10 cm to 60 cm are also used. And then we have plumb bob for leveling. And then arrows having top diameter of 50 mm, and then bottom stick having a diameter of 4 mm with a total of 40 cm length. And then ranging rods with red and white bands alternatively. The total length of the ranging rod varies from 1 meter to 3 meters. This is a 20 meter metric chain with brass handles at both the ends. The first link and the last link will be connected with the brass handles. It has a total number of 100 links, with each link having a 20 centimeter length. And then for connecting two links, we will be having a brass rings. And at the end of 5 meters, it will be 5 brass rings with a diameter of 13 centimeter. And then we will be having tallies at 5, 10 and 15 meter intervals, and these tallies will be having a number representation of 1, 2 and then 3. This metric chain is also available in 5 meters, 10 meters, 20 meters and 30 meters. Also we have Gunter's chain. The total length is in feet, that is 66 feet of 100 links, and the engineer's chains, it has 100 feet of 100 links. Revenue chain, the total length is 33 feet with 16 links, and finally steel band, which is similar to metric chain, that is 20 or 30 meters length. Now let us see the terminologies in chain surveying. For example, if an area is given, what are all the main station, what are all the subsidiary station and tie stations, we'll discuss now. Initially we'll start with main stations. The boundary stations are known as main stations. For example, this is a given plot where A, B, C and D are the main stations. Here the line connecting A, B, B, C, C, D and A, D and also B, D are main survey lines.
Now after connecting the main survey lines, we have to create subsidiary stations. These subsidiary stations are created at the main survey lines in order to divide the given area into number of triangles, the two well-conditioned triangles. And they are named as S1 and S2. Next to subsidiary station, we have tie stations. For example, if there is a road crossing our given area, then we have to locate the interior details of the road. So that I am forming an additional subsidiary station, that is a tie station T1 and T2. These T1 and T2 are connected by tie lines so that the interior details of the road can be formulated. Overall, in this plan of chain surveying, the lines joining AB, BC, CD, AD and BD are main survey lines, whereas the lines joining S1 and A, S2 and C are check lines which are connecting the subsidiary stations, and T1 and T2 are tie stations. The connecting lines is known as tie lines. Among all of the survey lines, baseline is very important. The longest of this main survey line is known as baseline. In this diagram, the line connecting BD is known as baseline. With the help of all of the survey stations and by doing the chain surveying procedures such as ranging, chaining and offsetting, we can calculate the total area of the plot or any other plot by chain surveying.